It was an invitation out of the blue and one that intrigued us. Come along to our funeral trade show, it said. Have a nosy, see some new developments, meet some interesting types.
Well, we couldn't resist. Who doesn't love a funeral trade show? Who to send, though? Michael Holland put his hand up.
It wasn't exactly how I'd planned to spend the day. Talking death with those I presumed to be deadly dull.
I love it. I love it, Michael.
Emphasis on presumed to be.
How do you describe your ensemble?
Normal.
The reality here at a funeral industry trade show, to which, surprisingly, we were the only media invited, refreshing both in age.
7 years in, so still young, still learning.
And outlook.
Nothing else you'd rather do?
Nothing. Nothing at all.
And if loud shirts are your way of drawing attention to your equally loud creations...
It's a bit over the top, really, but you got to have some fun when you go out.
Then that's just fine.
What's possibly over the top about that?
Just the glitter.
Just the glitter.
Why were you happy for us to come here today?
We want people to understand that there are all sorts of options available for people now to have a meaningful farewell that works for them, as opposed to just fitting into the old traditional image of what funerals are. So having you come along here gives us an opportunity to show that.
So what is new? What separates us from the staid old visions we conjure? Well, Brad from Whakatane is a good start.
You're 16, you need to start figuring out what you want to do. And I was looking through my careers book and funeral directing jumped out at me. I remember thinking, that could be me.
After 3 months washing hearses,
I really wanted to learn what happened behind those doors. I'm 23 now, I was 20 when I bought my own business.
If I'm out with my friends and somebody wants to talk about it, I'll just, what do you want to know? Ask me a question and I'll tell you, because there's no point in hiding what we do or why we do it.
Across the way, Maggie Mitchell telling the story of her enterprising husband, Andy, who conceived these personalised plywood caskets when his father was in the final stages of a terminal illness.
They're held together with wedges, so there's no glue, screws or tools to assemble them, and that's what we really like, is try to keep it as natural as possible.
The couple taking out international patents to protect their innovation, only for the unthinkable.
And unfortunately, Andy died last year.
3 weeks after a devastating diagnosis, 50-year-old Andy was carried out in one of his own.
He had his racing car on one side because he loved racing, and the brakes were glowing red. It reflected the man inside.
There's a walking urn.
A walking urn.
Nana's ashes go in there. You go to her favourite spot, you remove the clip, and then you can take it for a walk. And each time you press down, a small portion of ash is deposited out the end.
You could sprinkle her along the whole trail that she walked with Fido every morning.
Absolutely you could.
This is what we call a digital memorial.
A quick response code attached to the headstone, activating photos and videos of a loved one for current and future generations to access.
Hear and see the person. Absolutely, yeah.
I was told I'll never be a funeral director until I'm 25.
Prove them wrong.
Prove them wrong.
Prove them wrong.
I love what I do. I do.
What do you think about the with the walking urn?
The walking urn is me, and I hope, Mr. B, you're just taking down details, because I really would like that. Cremate me. I don't want to be buried anywhere, but just sort of tap me out on a nice path, down at the beach, wherever you like. Mm. What about you?
Giant statue.
Pardon?
Of myself. Big statue of myself, and you push a button and I say things. So, I don't want to record them beforehand, just get them off the TVNZ log.
Like
things about the cat. I love pussy. Stuff like that.
Things about the cat. Yeah. Lovely.
Stuff like that.
That's interesting. A statue. Yeah. And where would it be? Would it be in your home?
Outside TVNZ.
People pay money to come and see that. That's good.